make a new document. I'm choosing 1500 by 1500. Center it by pressing Ctrl 0. Make sure you have only fill, only stroke and not fill selected. Go to the polygon tool, click on your artboard, have 6 sides selected and radius as 600. You can choose a different number, but remember the number. Center it, holding shift, rotate it by 90 degrees. This will lock it in place. So you have the pointy end on top. Deselect everything. You can use the line segment tool or the pen tool. I'm choosing the pen tool. Click on the top intersect and draw a straight line till the bottom intersect point. Control press, click outside to deselect. Select the new line. Hit R on your keyboard. Double click on the rotate tool and type in 30 degrees and hit copy. Press Ctrl D to repeat the process. Now hit L on your keyboard to select the ellipse tool and remember the radius of the hexagon. So you need to have 600. Center the circle. This circle perfectly divides each segment in two parts. Deselect everything and use the circle tool again and holding shift and alt on your keyboard, draw out a circle which touches the two lower edges of the hexagon and the triangle on top. Try to make it as precise as possible. Use Ctrl Y to go to outline mode. Use the zoom tool to see. As you can see, it's a bit over. So for me, this I can adjust it a bit as well. If you need smaller adjustments, hold the Ctrl key. Hold the press bar, space bar, and move the design around. For me, 519 pixels work. It might be different for you. Again, press Ctrl Y to leave outline mode. With the circle selected, press R on your keyboard and Ctrl click and Alt click at the center and hit. Type 30 degrees and hit copy. Press Ctrl D to repeat the process. Now you need to draw another circle at this intersect point. Shift and Alt on your keyboard pressed, you can draw out a circle. Again, this needs to be as precise as possible. Like before, use the zoom tool and hit Ctrl Y to go to outline mode and correct it. Try to keep it as precise as possible. This will help later. 519 works for me. This new circle selected, hit Ctrl C and Ctrl F to copy and paste in place and change the size of the new circle. I am choosing 460 pixels. This is the size of your design. This will be the width actually of each of the segments. Now selecting both, press R on your keyboard and Ctrl click on the center and hit copy with a 60 degree rotation. Press Ctrl D to repeat. Again make a circle with the new dimension 460. Place it in the circle in between the six circles and choose any one of you want. Shift click the outer one and click it to make it bold, and this will be your target circle. Now center both circles. With the smaller circle selected, hit R on your keyboard and control click in the center and make a 60 degree rotation. Hit copy and control D to repeat it. Now you need to delete some of the guides you have made earlier. So start with the pentagon or the hexagon actually. You don't need this anymore, delete it, and the straight lines also. And also you will need to delete the inner circle. Select everything and go to your Pathfinder window and hit divide. With the design tool still selected, right click and hit ungroup. You won't need this anymore. Now you need to delete some parts. I'm speeding it up a bit so that it is not boring for you. Delete the inner parts also, it helps later. Increase the size so it makes things easier to view. Select everything and select the shape builder tool. Now you have to make the design. This is the basic over under design as all Celtic artworks are. If you make a mistake, hit Ctrl Z on your keyboard and go back to repeat the process. How many redos or undos you want, you can select that with from your preference menu. If needed, keep a picture of the design to help you as a guide, because you make a mistake here and the desired effect won't be there. With the interlacing completed, you need to knock out the internal parts or the design won't be transparent. So keeping everything selected, with the shape builder tool, press Alt on your keyboard and you can see the arrowhead changes from a plus to a minus, and click on the parts you don't want to keep. This will help you to place the design on any background you want and make it transparent. Alt will come with a white background. To see if you have done it right, move it to a neutral background. I'm just moving it outside the artboard. And you can see it's all transparent. Hit Ctrl Z to go back. That's your basic design. But now you need to color it. You can go for the black and white effect, but I'm choosing a colored effect. Select everything, select the Live Paint Bucket tool. I'm going to give it a 4 color effect. Choose whatever color you want, depend on you. I do apologize for the background noise. Choose your color effect as per you desire. This is the kind of effect I'm going for. That's your design. Now let's put a background behind it. Select the rectangle tool and shift pressed on your keyboard. Draw out a square which is larger than the design. Now give it a color. And center it. Right click on the square and go to arrange and send it to back. That's your basic design.